Hey everyone, welcome back to What's Happening. So we know on this past January 29th, Rickey Smiley's son, Brandon Smiley, had unexpectedly passed away. But in the wake of his son's untimely death, Rickey said that he's praying his way through and he's leaning on his spirituality. On today, this morning, he was live in Studio 1A giving his first interview on the Today Show. Let's take a listen to what he had to say.
We are back with an exclusive conversation with radio host and comedian Rickey Smiley. Rickey is here this morning with a really important message. For years, of course, you know, he's been a daily dose of laughs for listeners of his nationally syndicated morning show. Well, today, Rickey is speaking out on television for the first time about his son, Brandon. Brandon died on January 29th, and his dad is here this morning to talk, first of all, about how he and his family are coping and about some important warnings for parents as well. Good to see you, my friend.
Thank you for coming. Thank you for having me.
Our deepest
Appreciate
condolences.
You. Yes, sir.
First of all, you get the call that no parent ever wants to get, that that your child has passed away. What happened, Rickey?
I was in Dallas at my apartment, getting ready to watch the playoff. His girlfriend called. She said, "Text Brandon at this number, or call him." So I called. Nobody answered. I called her back. I said, "Is everything okay?" She was crying, and she said that, in her words, she said that he had OD'd. And so I called, and that was around 10. There was a 12 o'clock flight leaving Dallas, so I just kind of grabbed my backpack and jumped on the plane. And I flew to Birmingham, and I got a phone call on my way out the door from Brandon's younger sister that lives in Atlanta, Taylor, that he had passed. And she was crying, and yeah.
Had there been a history of drug use that you knew about?
Yeah, he was struggling with that. We had his mother and I made several attempts to try to send him to get the help that he needed, send him to rehab. And we thought that he was doing better. He had just joined the church. He had just got baptized again, probably a month before he passed away. And, you know, he went in, he used, and it killed him. But we haven't got a toxicology report yet. So this is just what we're speculating, according to his girlfriend who found him unresponsive.
And the cause of death, we should point out, is pending because of some additional lab studies that are needed. But you mentioned that he has had a history, and you're here this morning to talk to other parents as well who may have a child who's dealing with addiction issues.
Yeah, we have to have a conversation. But I think the parents are having the conversation. Mm-hmm. The problem is getting the kids to listen to what the parents are saying. The parents are having these conversations. Some of them are uncomfortable, and we just assume that if, you know, you're in a good school district or you're in a gated community or everything's going good, that these kids are not, you know, doing drugs. You don't have to be in the hood, to succumb to drug abuse. So Brandon, we had been talking to him for years. I don't know why. I don't know how. His mother is clean and sober her whole life. She lives in Atlanta with Brandon's bonus father. And myself, we are all clean and sober. And I don't know. I hate it.
What was he like for folks who didn't know him?
Yeah, fun, funny, always the leader, always the prankster. This picture right here, I was surprised him that weekend, took him to Busch Garden that weekend on the plane there. We were flying out to L.A. when I was taping BET Comic View graduation. He was a great kid. He came to live with me at the end of his eighth grade year. I wanted to, you know, have an opportunity to see him into his manhood. And probably about 11th or 12th grade, it started getting bad or whatever. So I thought I had control of it. Took him off to Alabama State University. Then I sent him to the University of Alabama. After that, he started doing comedy. He started doing stand-up comedy.
He wanted to be like Dad.
Yeah, he was getting, you know, he was doing some stuff with Roy Wood Jr. from Saturday Night Live, who's also from Birmingham. He had some wonderful opportunities. I had him on stage when he was 7 years old. He wanted to perform. Just a great kid, a lot of life. Every amusement park in the country, he loved roller coasters. A lot of fun.
Rickey, you've been making folks laugh for decades now. One of the funniest folks out there. How are you? How are you holding up in this moment?
I just have to. I'm doing good. God had kind of gave me a sense that, that I'm shocked but not surprised. Or whatever. I understand what's out there.
Yeah.
I understand what's going on. And God just kind of showed me some things. So I was deep inside kind of prepared for it, you know. But at the same time, when it happens, you can never be prepared because that's your child. But I'm doing good. I still have to do my morning show. I still have to press my way through, pray my way through, lean on my spirituality, because the God that we serve is just awesome. Have given me peace that surpasses all understanding. And if anything make me cry, it's God's goodness to be able to get out of the bed, to be able to do my morning show, to be able to protect the rest of my kids, my grandkids, and the rest of my family. So I just thank God for his grace and his mercy.
Take care of yourself, okay?
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Rickey Smiley, third hour today, right back after this.
Rickey Smiley's message is profound, and I love how he continues to lean on his faith in God, which, as he said, has given him peace that surpasses all understanding. And we know that that peace can only come from God. So sound out below. Let me know your thoughts on this. And as always, I thank you for watching and listening, and I will talk to you in the next video.